Big brother over there. You know, I thought moving out to LA might mellow him out a little. He's still trying to tell me what to do.
Well, I would not worry about him. I'm sure it won't be too long before he jets back to the coast and whatever the hell it is he does out there.
Still no word from Dad.
Well, I'm sure he'll turn up.
He missed his own son's wedding, and now the reception's half over. Where the hell is he?
Dimitri, relax. Look, Dad's been a little weird lately.
I did notice he was on edge last night.
Well, he's on edge every night. Frankly, I'm worried about him. I don't know how much longer he's going to be able to run Spyder games.
Really? I wonder who's in line to take over that job.
Well, that would be me. You know, the one who didn't abandon the family.
Invitation, please.
Oh, I'm with her.
Her who?
Hello again.
Great party, huh?
It's improving.
I've been trying to get you alone all day, but every time I come looking for you, you vanish.
So now I'm the mysterious one.
What do you mean by that?
I mean, you still haven't told me what you were really doing in my father's office last night.
Killing time. Waiting for you to drop back into my life.
With lines like that, you must be a real babe magnet.
Well, babes are easy to find. I'm looking for a woman.
No, you don't understand.
Yeah, I do. No invitation, no entry. Now, let's go.
Is there a problem here?
She was trying to sneak in.
No, I was not sneaking.
Of course you weren't. Drop this, man.
Thanks. See?
Sorry about that, ma'am.
You should be. Where do they get these guys?
Casting off the Sopranos.
Thanks for rescuing me.
Right place, right time.
My girlfriend talked me into crashing this party, and of course I'm the one that gets busted.
Why'd you crash this wedding?
To meet Boris Carlyle.
What would you want with him?
Well, his real estate company owns the building I'm leasing, and I need to talk to him.
Let me guess, he's screwing you over.
How'd you know?
I've heard stories. In fact, word is that all the Carlyles are kind of whacked.
Oh, so you're a friend of the bride's.
Would you like a drink?
Love one.
Wow. This place is beautiful.
A girl only loses her virginity once.
You're the best thing that's ever happened to me. You know that.
Yes. But I never get tired of hearing it.
Julie, I'm sorry.
It's your dad, isn't it? I don't blame you. I know how upset you were that he didn't come today.
Forget about my father. He's not going to be a part of our lives anymore.
Okay. I won't bring it up again.
Now, where were we?
I have an idea. But you need to take off the rest of your clothes.
You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals, so let's do it like they do on the Discovery Channel.
Morris Carlyle won't spend a dime to keep my place up to code, but he bankrolls this obnoxious display. I mean, Hal Aaron Spelling is that thing. What a waste of...
ice?
Exactly.
How about some champagne? I hear the Carlyles poured over the Rice Krispies. Be right back.
Mm-hmm.
Cherish, you made it.
Of course I did. How's the party?
Kind of strange. My dad bailed. Total no-show.
Ouch. Cherish, hello. So how'd you convince your dad?
I'm at the library.
Oh, Sasha, this is my friend Taylor Marcos. She works at Daphne's store, too.
Hi, Sasha Carlyle.
Nice to meet you. You know, I have to make a phone call and... I forgot my cell.
No problem. I'll show you where the phones are. Go get some food. There's lobster.
Great. I'll see you in a minute.
Okay.
She moves like she don't care. Smooth as silk.
Hi, Cherish. You decided to come after all.
I took your advice. I'm tired of my dad treating me like I'm on parole. I hope you don't mind I closed up early.
Well, of course not. I'm glad you're here. Would you look at all this food?
Daphne, you lived on nothing but cup of noodles since the store opened. Eat, girl.
Okay, maybe just a taste. By the way, that dress looks great on you.
Thanks. I borrowed it from the store along with $20 from the register for a cab.
This may be the wildest night of your life. I saw you over there talking to Sasha Carlyle.
Isn't he the hottest guy ever?
Oh, I just met the hottest guy ever. You know what they say, weddings are the place to hook up.
Am I glad to see you?
Easy, someone might see us.
You got this, my big bro. We better get out of here.
So that's Dimitri. You know, it won't be very long before my father officially retires from Spyder Games. And then I'm going to take over.
Well, I'd better hang around with you now before you get a little too high-powered for me.
Well, lucky for you, I can still squeeze you in.
Why don't we go for a walk?
Sasha, where are you?
I've been thinking about doing this since I was 16 years old.
What, feeding me a piece of $2,000 wedding cake?
No. This.
Excuse me, Miss Carlyle.
You wouldn't believe the line at the bar. Who do you have to know to get fast service around here?
Probably Boris Carlyle. Oh, I wish I could find him. I want to tell him what a butthole I think he is before I lose my nerve.
Maybe I should ask you to dance before I lose mine.
I believe that fate has brought us here. And we should be together, babe. But we're not.
Oh, my God. No!
I'll keep my cool, but I try to say goodbye.
gotta go check in with my family.
See you later.
So have you always hated rich people?
I don't hate them. I intend to be one myself someday. It's the arrogance I can't stand. I mean, just because the Carlyles own half the town, I'm supposed to be impressed.
It's clearly what they're going for.
My idea of a good time is deep dish pizza in South Park.
Girl, like South Park? Wow. There's a marathon on tomorrow night.
Really? I can't wait.
So your TV or mine? Excuse me. I'll be right back. What's going on?
I don't know, but there's a cop here.
Lieutenant Henry Pardee, Fort Kent Police.
You gotta get me out of here. My dad just showed up.
Cherish, I can't leave. I'm about to hook up with a gorgeous guy.
Okay, so you'll have a date and I'll be dead.
Well, where's Taylor?
I have no idea, Daphne, please. I'll work on Christmas.
All right, come on.
I really, really appreciate this. Daphne, what's wrong?
I didn't even get his name.
Whose name?
The guy I was dancing with.
Daphne, that was Dimitri Carlyle.
Dimitri what? How does that feel?
Amazing. You're really good at this, Julie. What other talents have you been hiding from me?
If you roll over, you'll find out.
Yes, what is it?
Ivan, it's Dimitri. It's important.
Come in. Sorry to bother you guys, but we need you to come downstairs.
Why?
There's been an accident. Dad's dead.
Looks like your father lost control of his Mercedes on Miller's Ridge Road. He skidded over the embankment and died on impact.
Miller's Ridge?
It can be pretty treacherous in the rain.
But it hasn't rained all day.
We think it happened late last night.
And you just discovered it?
The car landed in a secluded spot, lots of trees.
Lieutenant, is there anything else?
We're still waiting on the toxicology report, but from what you've told me, it seems pretty clear what happened to classic DUI.
Dad had a few drinks, but he didn't have a problem holding it. He wasn't drunk.
It doesn't take much liquor to impair someone's control. Unfortunately, some people learn this lesson the hard way. I'm sorry. Which one of you is going to handle the arrangements?
I will.
What's this?
A few things from your father's car.
Thanks.
Sasha, I'm sorry for your loss. But I need you to do me a favor.
What's that?
Stay away from my daughter.
Cherish.
My dad just got home and told me about your father. I came right over.
I can't believe it.
I'm so sorry.
Thanks.
Sure. Do you want to talk or go for a walk or anything? I mean, since I'm here.
I think I need to be alone.
Yeah, of course. That's cool.
Oh, well, thanks for stopping by. I mean, you're...
You're great. I'll call you tomorrow.
My wallet. What are you doing here?
I met the man of my dreams tonight.
So that's why you're upset?
Taylor, he's Boris Carlyle's son.
Dimitri?
That's the one. Of course, I didn't know his name until after I spent the entire evening bad-mouthing the whole Carlyle family. God, look at this hat. What was I thinking?
Daph, focus. Now look, he didn't tell you who he was.
No, I guess he was too nice to let me know what a huge bitch I was being.
Look, what you have to do is go down to that reception and straighten this out with Dimitri.
Now?
Yes, yes. Look, you finally get out of here long enough to meet a hot guy, so don't lose him.
What if I already have?
Then you get him back. Look, you'll regret it the rest of your life if you don't. Now, go.
You're right. Who would have thought such a horrible man like Boris would have fathered such a cute son?
Not me. Bye. What was she thinking?
Crash. My dad's dead. I don't want to be alone tonight.
Still here.
I wanted to make sure that you were okay. Did they say how it happened?
It was a car accident.
Natalia, is there anything that I could do?
No. I'm just waiting to go to the morgue. I have to ID the body and make all the arrangements.
I'll go with you. Natalia, you shouldn't have to go through this alone.
That's really sweet of you, but actually, this is something that I have to do alone.
Okay. Once again, if there's anything that I could do for you, you call me. Day or night.
Thank you, I will.
I was listening to this.
Dimitri, I am so embarrassed. Please, before you say anything, let me explain. See, I have this evil, mouthy twin, and while she really hates obnoxious rich people, I have no problem with them. Not that you're obnoxious. You're cute. Gorgeous, actually. God, I can do better than that. But first I have to pee.
Hey, it's Dimitri. Can you come to Fort Kent right away? My dad was killed last night in a car crash. Police say he was alone, but I don't think so. I have this terrible feeling it wasn't an accident.